The saber, British English, or saber, American English, is a type of backsword with a curved blade associated with the light cavalry of the early modern and Napoleonic periods. Originally associated with Central Eastern European cavalry such as the Hussars, the saber became widespread in Western Europe in the Thirty Years' War. Lighter sabers also became popular with infantry of the late 17th century. In the 19th century, models with less curving blades became common and were also used by heavy cavalry. The last saber issued to U.S. cavalry was the Patton Saber of 1913. Zablat WZ 34 was the last saber issued to the Polish cavalry, in 1934. The military saber was used as a dueling weapon in academic fencing in the 19th century, giving rise to a discipline of modern saber fencing, introduced in the 1896 Summer Olympics, loosely based on the characteristics of the historical weapon in that it allows for cuts as well as thrusts. Name: English saber is recorded from the 1670s, as a direct loan from French, where the saber is an alteration of sable, which was in turn loaned from German Sabel in the 1630s. The German word is on record from the 15th century, loaned from Polish Zablat, which was itself adopted from Hungarian Zablat, 14th century, later Zablaya. The spread of the Hungarian word to neighboring European languages took place in the context of the Ottoman Wars in Europe of the 15th to 17th centuries. The spelling saber becomes common in American English in the second half of the 19th century. The origin of the Hungarian word is unclear. It may itself be a loan from South Slavic, Serbo-Croatian, from a common Slavic asterisk sabluja, which would ultimately derives from a Turkic source. In a more recent suggestion, the Hungarian word may ultimately derive from a Tungusic source, via Kipchak Turkic celebi, with later metathesis of LB to BL, and apocope changed to asterisk spl, which would have changed its vocalization in Hungarian to the recorded sabla, perhaps under the influence of the Hungarian word sab to crop, cut, into shape. History. Origins. Though single-edged cutting swords existed in ancient and early medieval Europe, such as the Greek Machaira and the Germanic Ceyx, the direct predecessor of the saber appears in the context of the Eurasian steppes in the medieval period, connected to the Magyars and the Turkic expansion. These oldest sabers had a slight curve, short, downturned quillons, the grip facing the opposite direction to the blade and a sharp point with the top third of the reverse edge sharpened. Early modern period. The introduction of the saber proper in Western Europe, along with the term saber itself, dates to the 17th century, via influence of the Eastern European Zablat type ultimately derived from these medieval backswords. The adoption of the term is connected to the employment of Hungarian Hussar, cavalry by Western armies at the time. Hungarian Hussars were employed as light cavalry, with the role of harassing enemy skirmishers, overrunning artillery positions, and pursuing fleeing troops. In the late 17th and 18th centuries, many Hungarian Hussars fled to other Central and Western European countries and became the core of light cavalry formations created there. The Hungarian term Zablaya is ultimately traced to the northwestern Turkic celebi, with contamination from the Hungarian verb sab to cut. The original type of saber, or Polish Zablat, was used as a cavalry weapon, possibly inspired by Hungarian or wider Turco-Mongol warfare. The karabela was a type of zablat popular in the late 17th century, worn by the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth nobility class, the zlachta. While designed as a cavalry weapon, it also came to replace various types of straight-bladed swords used by infantry. The Swiss saber originates as a regular sword with a single-edged blade in the early 16th century, but by the 17th century begins to exhibit specialized hilt types. Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth. In the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, 16th-18th century, a specific type of saber-like melee weapon, the zablat, was used. Richly decorated sabers were popular among the Polish nobility, who considered it to be one of the most important pieces of men's traditional attire. With time, the design of the saber greatly evolved in the Commonwealth and gave birth to a variety of saber-like weapons, intended for many tasks. In the following centuries, The ideology of Sarmatism, as well as the Polish fascination with Eastern cultures, customs, cuisine, and warfare, resulted in the zabla becoming an indispensable part of traditional Polish attire. Modern use. The saber saw extensive military use in the early 19th century, particularly in the Napoleonic Wars, during which Napoleon used heavy cavalry charges to great effect against his enemies. Shorter versions of the saber were also used as sidearms by dismounted units, although these were gradually replaced by fascine knives and sword bayonets as the century went on. Although there was extensive debate over the effectiveness of weapons such as the saber and lance, the saber remained the standard weapon of cavalry for mounted action in most armies until World War I. Thereafter, it was gradually relegated to the status of a ceremonial weapon, and most horse cavalry was replaced by armored cavalry from 1930 on. Napoleonic era. Sabers were commonly used by the British in the Napoleonic era for light cavalry and infantry officers, as well as others. The elegant but effective 1803 pattern sword that the British government authorized for use by infantry officers during the wars against Napoleon featured a curved saber blade, which was often blued and engraved by the owner in accordance with his personal taste, and was based on the famously agile 1796 light cavalry saber that was renowned for its brutal cutting power. Sabers were commonly used throughout this era by all armies, in much the same way that the British did. The popularity of the saber had rapidly increased in Britain throughout the 18th century for both infantry and cavalry use. This influence was predominantly from southern and eastern Europe, with the Hungarians and Austrians listed as sources of influence for the sword and style of swordsmanship in British sources. The popularity of sabers had spread rapidly through Europe in the 16th and 17th century, and finally came to dominance as a military weapon in the British Army in the 18th century, though straight blades remained in use by some, such as heavy cavalry units. These were also replaced by sabers soon after the Napoleonic era. The introduction of pattern swords in the British Army in 1788 led to a brief departure from the saber in infantry use, though not for light cavalry, in favor of the lighter and straight-bladed spadroon. The spadroon was universally unpopular, and many officers began to unofficially purchase and carry sabers once more. In 1799, the army accepted this under regulation for some units, and in 1803, produced a dedicated pattern of saber for certain infantry officers, flank, rifle, and staff officers. The 1803 pattern quickly saw much more widespread use than the regulation intended due to its effectiveness in combat and fashionable appeal. Pattern 1796 light cavalry saber. The most famous British saber of the Napoleonic era is the 1796 light cavalry model, used by troopers and officers alike. Officers' versions can vary a little, but are much the same as the pattern trooper's sword. It was in part designed by the famous John L. E. Marchant, British Army officer, born 1766, who worked to improve on the previous, 1788, design based on his experience with the Austrians and Hungarians. L. E. Marchant also developed the first official British military sword exercise manual based on this experience, and his light cavalry saber and style of swordsmanship went on to heavily influence the training of the infantry and the navy. The 1796 light cavalry sword was known for its brutal cutting power, easily severing limbs, and leading to the unsubstantiated myth that the French put in an official complaint to the British about its ferocity. This sword also saw widespread use with mounted artillery units, and the numerous militia units established in Britain to protect against a potential invasion by Napoleon. Though the saber had already become very popular in Britain, experience in Egypt did lead to a fashion trend for Mameluke sword-style blades, a type of Middle Eastern scimitar, by some infantry and cavalry officers. These blades differ from the more typical British ones in that they have more extreme curve, and are usually not fullered, and taper to a finer point. Mameluke swords also gained some popularity in France as well. Arthur Wellesley, 1st Duke of Wellington, himself carried a Mameluke-style sword. In 1831, the Mameluke sword became the pattern sword for British generals, as well as officers of the United States Marine Corps, and is still in use today. United States. The American victory over the rebellious forces in the citadel of Tripoli in 1805, during the First Barbary War, led to the presentation of bejeweled examples of these swords to the senior officers of the U.S. Marines. Officers of the U.S. Marine Corps still use a Mameluke pattern dress sword. Although some genuine Turkish Kılıç sabers were used by Westerners, most Mameluke sabers were manufactured in Europe. Although their hilts were very similar in form to the Ottoman prototype, their blades, even when an expanded yelmen was incorporated, tended to be longer, narrower and less curved than those of the true Kılıç. In the American Civil War, the saber was used infrequently as a weapon, but saw notable deployment in the Battle of Brandy Station and at East Cavalry Field at the Battle of Gettysburg in 1863. Many cavalrymen, particularly on the Confederate side, eventually abandoned the long, heavy weapons in favor of revolvers and carbines. The last saber issued to U.S. cavalry was the Patton Saber of 1913, designed to be mounted to the cavalryman's saddle. A War Department circular dated April 18, 1934 announced that the saber would no longer be issued to cavalry and was to be completely discarded for use as a weapon. Only dress sabers for use by officers as a badge of rank were to be retained. Police. During the 19th and into the early 20th century, sabers were also used by both mounted and dismounted personnel in some European police forces. When the saber was used by mounted police against crowds, the results could be appalling, as portrayed in a key scene in Dr. Zhivago. The saber was later phased out in favor of the baton, or nightstick, for both practical and humanitarian reasons. The Gendarmerie of Belgium used them until at least 1950, and the Swedish police forces until 1965. Contemporary dress uniform. Swords with saber blades remain a component of the dress uniforms worn by most National Army, Navy, Air Force, Marine, and Coast Guard officers. Some militaries also issue ceremonial swords to their highest-ranking non-commissioned officers. This is seen as an honor since, typically, non-commissioned, enlisted/other rank military service members are instead issued a cutlass blade rather than a saber. Sword deployments in the modern military are no longer intended for use as weapons, and now serve primarily in ornamental or ceremonial functions. As such, they are typically made of stainless steel, a material which keeps its shine bright but is much too brittle for direct impacts, let alone full blade-on-blade combat, and may shatter if such usage is attempted. One distinctive ceremonial function a saber serves in modern times is the saber arch, performed for servicemen or women getting married. Modern sport fencing. The modern fencing saber bears little resemblance to the cavalry saber, having a thin, 88 cm, 35 in, long straight blade. Rather, it is based upon the Italian dueling saber of classical fencing. One of the three weapons used in the sport of fencing, it is a very fast-paced weapon with bouts characterized by quick footwork and cutting with the edge. The only allowed target area is from the waist up, the region a mounted man could reach on a foe on the ground. The concept of attacking above the waist only is a 20th century change to the sport. Previously sabrers used to pad their legs against cutting slashes from their opponents. The reason for the above-waist rule is unknown, as the sport of saber fencing is based on the use of infantry sabers, not cavalry sabers. Type sword. Service history. Wars. Early modern warfare, Ottoman Wars, Napoleonic Wars, American Revolution, American Civil War, Franco-Prussian War, World War I, Polish-Soviet War. Production history. Produced early modern period.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.